The gig economy is being misframed. See, when you think DoorDash or Uber, you think, yeah, that's a great side hustle, but consider it to be a little more than that today. I'm going to take you through my day. It's just a normal Thursday in the middle of August. Instead of like in my other videos where we're running up as much money as we possibly can, the goal today is to focus on quality of life. We want to see today if we can earn enough in the gig economy without our work feeling like a burden. Let's maximize the enjoyment of this day, and as you're watching, I want you to consider, what is the value of this to you? My favorite time to start a gig economy delivery job would be right when I wake up. The roads are clear, the air is cool. I found this 3-hour estimated shift on Amazon Flex paying $87. So I head to the warehouse. I'm assigned one cart of packages to deliver, and I'm walking through some pretty full carts until I get to my cart, which appears almost empty. 7 packages for me this morning. That's nothing. We can get this done in no time. Like we always do with this time. It is so beautiful today. The air feels so nice. Here we go. I've got a bit of a drive home. It'll be about 7:15 when I get there. I'm gonna pick up the girls and we're gonna go take advantage of this awesome weather. What's up, ladies? What's up, ladies? Brady's jumping. Brady's jumping. Y'all wanna go to the park? Let's go to the park. We've got these awesome trails on the Catawba River within 5 minutes of our house. The girls and I headed to our favorite water access point, but today we weren't alone. After a short wait, thankfully it was our turn in the water. I took Peyton and Brady back home, but then went back out for maybe my favorite activity of the day. I love getting shots up in the gym. I absolutely splashed this 3, and then in case you thought it was a fluke, I'll give you another one in your mouth. Next, I practice my mid-range game. And believe it or not though, I am actually capable of missing. I missed my second attempt here, and I also missed from the corner. But as any good shooter knows, you always end practice on a make. Back home, shower time, and how about a nap to offset the fact that we had an early morning? Nap time was good, but I'm gonna get back out here and DoorDash for 1 or 2 hours at lunch. Made my first pickup. It's this order from Big Wok. Part of the value of the gig lifestyle to me is the fluidity of it. Like, I don't know what I'll end up doing today, but theoretically, I could end up working an 8-hour workday. You know, 4 hours to start our morning off, 2 hours at lunch, 2 hours at dinner. That would be a full day's work, but at no point would I have felt tired or felt overworked because I have massive breaks in between shifts. It just feels like a super easy way for me to go about things, to divide the work up into very small chunks like that. Hey there.
Hey.
Delivery for Tammy.
Yep, thank you so much.
Enjoy it. I got myself a bite to eat before we head to the next DoorDash pickup. I'm gonna have to try this cheesy Chipotle chicken flatbread combo.
All right.
I'll have a Mountain Dew with that. You guys know by now, I crush Taco Bell in these videos. You gotta remember, for the most part, when you're seeing me eat, I'm on the road, on the move, and I need something really convenient. I swear, not every meal is like this. Time to serve our second customer. Hey, for calling?
Yes.
Careful, these are drinks.
Okay.
And here's your drink.
Thank you.
Have a good day.
You too.
Hidden tipped again on that delivery. That puts my earnings for the day over $100 already. I got offered another DoorDash order I like. Let's go take care of it. The best version of this lifestyle for me would be, you know, house paid off, accounts funded, earning interest. That would take the pressure totally off. I'd be able to make the fun parts of the day the dominant part of the day. At that point, if all I have to earn is regular daily expenses, gas, food, taking care of my pets, electricity and property taxes, stuff like this, How much more than $100 a day would I really need to earn? I mean, we've barely cracked the afternoon and I've already earned enough today that would definitely have sustained the amount that I'm spending to survive and to have fun during this day. That's the other thing. You're gonna see most of the things that I'm showcasing as things that I enjoy to do. It's a pretty inexpensive lifestyle, but it's all I need. I mean, truly on a regular day, the things that I'm doing in this video, doing today, are what I really want to do. For instance, what I'm about to do next with my day is something I want to do, and it might be somewhat frowned upon, but it's free. I'm trying to spend a little more time reading. So you just head to a local Barnes & Noble or Books A Million and go inside. You got all the new releases available to you. You just spend 30 minutes or an hour, go pick up a book, go sit in the corner and read it, put it back on the shelf where you found it, and just remember what page you were on for the next day. Now you get to read anything you want at no cost. Walking inside, I always head straight for the business section. I look for something new. See, this is the type of nerdy thing I like to read. There's often a coffee shop inside these bookstores where you can find seating, and yeah, they want you to come in and buy a book or buy the coffee, but if you just do things in life with conviction, very few people have the balls to confront you about it. I really liked the beginning of this book. It's something about like not actually owning the book and having to go out and read it. It almost makes it even more intriguing. Like I really want to go back already and read some more. But once I was at a point that I felt that that was enough reading for the day, I fired up my DoorDash again and was fielding offers until one came up that made sense for me. So let's go ahead and handle this next delivery. Food deliveries into my own neighborhood are the absolute best. Right after my lunch delivery session, I always feed the dogs, and Brady likes to eat right away, but Peyton prefers to get some one-on-one playtime with me while Brady is distracted. Once Peyton gets hungry, I have an opportunity to clean the house. I find that a little bit of time each day prevents the house from getting out of control dirty. If you're a GSD owner, put it in the comments. How often does this hair repopulate around your house? Once a day? Twice a day? Or 10 times a day? I play a couple games of Settlers of Catan online, and I like to raise the stakes immediately with my opponents, a couple of which followed through and subscribed to the channel. If you're watching, I appreciate you. I know we've gotten some exercise in today, but we haven't really gotten out in the sun yet. My city of Rock Hill has several quality disc golf locations. This very course that I'm on is Winthrop Lake. You can see the water behind me. This course is one of the best in the nation. It's used for our national championships. So this is also a free activity almost anywhere you do it around, at least where I live. Free, of course, unless you put one of your discs in the water and you can't get it back and you gotta go buy a new one. I've done that before here. This hole is interesting. You've got to go through the bamboo doorway, not over or around. Unfortunately, my drive fades left, but I finished the hole off strong. Obviously, I had to make it back home for my favorite part of the day. There she is. Hello.
Hey, baby.
Good to see you. We made a quick wardrobe change. Go Bears. This would not be a proper have fun in your day video if my day didn't end watching sports, specifically football, specifically the Bears. We are headed to Buffalo Wild Wings to watch the game tonight, but that's about 5 miles south of us. We might as well, if we're being smart, take a DoorDash on the way toward the restaurant, somewhat in the same direction, make a little bit of money as we drive to the destination we were headed to anyway. There we are, a nice little $6.25 to deliver an order that was on our way anyway. I'll take that anytime. The food is ready to go. We got our sampler plate and 10 boneless wings. Actually, I think it's 12, isn't it?
I think it's 12.
12 boneless wings. And we got the Bears on the TV in front of us with the lead and the ball. I know it's preseason, but it's been an encouraging game so far. I just drove home and I want to drive home the point. I earned a total of $121.11 today in the gig economy. during a day that was designed to emphasize just how enjoyable the day can be without having to sacrifice the ability to provide. I know today was worth sharing with you guys because I feel like I did this for myself, because I know how it would have impacted my decision making if I'd have watched this several years ago. Thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you're willing to give this channel some more viewership. The next video I'll be doing relating to the gig economy is next week. I'll be using the gig economy to fund a trip somewhere in the country I've never been before. You're gonna have to tune in to find out just where that is. That is next time on Wealthy. The good life, let's go on a living spree. They say the best things in life are free.